Capital, Part 1 of 3. By Karl Marx. Audiobook 5x55. The expression of the value of commodity A in terms of any other commodity B, merely distinguishes the value from the use value of A, and therefore places A merely in a relation of exchange with a single different commodity, B, but it is still far from expressing A's qualitative equality, and quantitative proportionality, to all commodities. To the elementary relative value form of a commodity, there corresponds the single equivalent form of one other commodity. Thus, in the relative expression of value of the linen, the coat assumes the form of equivalent, or of being directly exchangeable, only in relation to a single commodity, the linen. Nevertheless, the elementary form of value passes by an easy transition into a more complete form. It is true that by means of the elementary form, the value of a commodity A becomes expressed in terms of one, and only one, other commodity. But that one may be a commodity of any kind, coat, iron, corn, or anything else. Therefore, according as A is placed in relation with one or the other, we get for one and the same commodity, different elementary expressions of value. The number of such possible expressions is limited only by the number of the different kinds of commodities distinct from it. The isolated expression of A's value is therefore convertible into a series, prolonged to any length, of the different elementary expressions of that value. Total or expanded form of value. Z com. A equals U com. B or equals V com. C or equals W com. D or equals X com. E or equals 8C. 20 yards of linen equals 1 coat or equals 10 lb tea or equals 40 lb coffee or equals 1 quarter corn or equals 2 ounces gold or equals 1 half ton iron or equals 8C. The expanded relative form of value. The value of a single commodity, the linen, for example, is now expressed in terms of numberless other elements of the world of commodities. Every other commodity now becomes a mirror of the linen's value. It is thus, that for the first time this value shows itself in its true light as a congelation of undifferentiated human labor. For the labor that creates it, now stands expressly revealed, as labor that ranks equally with every other sort of human labor, no matter what its form, whether tailoring, plowing, mining, 8C. And no matter, therefore, whether it is realized in coats,